Praise the Lord, everyone.
Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord. We'd like to welcome you here to the Greater Refuge Global Ministries, located here in the city of Deland, where our pastor is Bishop James Darby, and serving along with him, my First Lady Mother Frances Darby. If you are tuning in for the first time, or you're here with us every Sunday, please go ahead and like this page. But most of all, go ahead and share, because there will be a blessing. Let me say that again. There is a blessing in this house. If you are here in the city, the doors are open, and we invite you here to our morning service at 316 South Adale Avenue. Let's give the Lord a praise, because we want to worship him on this morning. We want to honor the Lord, because the Lord is good. I surrender all to him, because he woke me up this morning. He started me on my way, and I just want to offer myself unto the Lord. Amen.
Thank you. give you praise and honor. We thank you, God, for the many blessings you bestowed upon us. We ask, God, that you would bless us like only you know how to bless us. Forgive us, Lord, of our sins and help us in the name of Jesus, we pray. We pray, God, for those who are listening, both foreign and domestically, that you would minister to the needs of your people. God, we ask you to bless the service this morning. We ask, God, a special blessing and prayer for our leader, that you continue to touch him, God. We pray for his companion. We pray, God, for this city. We pray, Lord, that you will remember those who are seeking you for salvation. We pray for the Spring Hill and the Carmike Oaks community, that, Lord, you will touch and move in a special way. Bless those who are here on today. You know the needs of your people even before we ask. Right now, in the name of Jesus, we look into you, people. We realize that you are the author and the finisher of our faith. Move and have your way on to this morning. Bless, Lord, we pray, God, that you would touch in a special way. Evangelist Cannon, Lord, remember Mother Walker, Mother Deacon, that you would touch their bodies in the name of Jesus. And all the prayer requests that have gone up before you, Lord, remember, God, we know that you've done it before and you can do it again. Bless us, Lord, and keep us as we shall be kept. This is our prayer in the name of Jesus we pray. Amen.
At this time, I just want you to know we are coming to you from the Greater Refuge Global Ministries here in the city of Deland. We're located at 316 South Adel Avenue, Deland, Florida. We also would like to share with you the way of giving. If you'd like to bless the house of God or sow a seed, not only into this ministry, but into our global ministry, you may do so by the way of PayPal. That's 38 Deland Refuge 386@gmail.com. That's DelandRefuge 386@gmail.com. Also, you may use GiveAfly. That's just Greater Refuge Deland. GiveAfly is Greater Refuge Deland. And our cash out is Greater Refuge Global Ministries. Global Ministries says Greater Refuge Global Ministries. All that information will be pinned in the live stream. It will be pinned for you in the live stream. Amen. So we want to praise and worship him. How do you know that Jesus is your everything? How do you love Jesus on this morning? How do you know that Jesus is your Savior? The song says, I love Jesus. He's my Savior. Come on, feel the Lord. Just say, let's clap hands together. Yeah.
Jesus. Bless his holy name. God has given him a name which is above every name, that at that name every knee should bow and every tongue confess that Jesus Christ is Lord. Thanks be to God for his many, many blessings that he has given to us. Undeserved, but yet we're blessed by him. I want to bring the word of God chosen from the book of Daniel, chapter 3. There's one verse in that chapter that I want to situate and take a subject of the text from that verse. We appreciate all the people of God, all of you that have come in the presence of the Lord on today to worship him, to give him praise, to honor an almighty, sovereign, unequaled God. The text is a simple text. It comes from a story that we've heard many, many times over periods of time. And the book of Daniel chapter 3. Daniel chapter 3. We have the story of three young men that were brought into Babylon. In their youth, they were getting young. But they made commitments to God. Decisions were made by him relevant as a test, relevant to their religious stand, their faith in God. They make choices. They made decisions, and the choices were firm, ironclad. They chose who they were going to serve. And were determined not to allow anything to stand in the way of their decision. In verse 19, chapter 3, then was Nebuchadnezzar full of fury, and the form of his vision was changed against Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego. Therefore we spake and commanded that they should heat the furnace 7 times more than it would want to be heated. Let's go back verses preceding the text. The king decided. Oh, he was a man of great splendor. A king that was unequaled and his day. He rose to such a status that he conquered everything close to him. The scene takes place in Babylon, today's Iraq. In Babylon, he rose a level, and the things that he did, and the military that he commanded, no one. He was blessed beyond measure, simply because God allowed him to reach such status. But he got besides himself. He decides one day that I want the whole kingdom to worship my God and a statue, a golden image that I think my craftsmen to construct. And I want to dedicate my statue, my image, and everyone in my kingdom, I want them to give reverence to my image. And if they don't bow to it, worship my God, they're going to be placed in a furnace of fire. And in this 19th verse, I'll go back in just a moment, but I need to bring visibly for our minds the subject of the text. He says in the 19th verse, I want the furnace to be heated 7 times. Hotter than it is already. I want the furnace turned up. And those that are going in there, I'm making sure that there's no escape, no escape. Now, the subject of the text is, when the heat, don't panic when the heat is turned up. Don't panic when the heat is turned up. So as the story goes, there were 3 young men, Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego. They were spied on. The devil always take note of your commitment to God. And it creates a test of your faith in God. So the king has this great big golden image standing 90 feet tall. You can see him from a far distance, 30 feet wide. He had hands. He has feet, and possibly put some eyes in it, maybe a gold, but the Bible doesn't say. And so he says, bring my orchestra together. Bring my band. musicians, multiple instruments, harps and saxophones and dulcimers, and the list goes on. And when the music sounds, I really found it about time and worship the image. So they played the music. It sounded. Knees were bowing all over the place, but these boys stood. Teenagers, they stood. They stood. King said, if you don't bow, I'm going into the fire. But they made a choice. Sometimes you have to make choices. And the choice you make to determine your destiny. The choice you make could affect your life for the rest of your life. They made this choice. We're not going to bow. So they come before the king. They didn't feel intimidated. We stand before the greatest king of the times. We're in the greatest kingdom that's existing at this time. But they're standing there. Why? Because they have faith in their God. King says, I understand, fellows, that you didn't bow down. I'm going to give you another chance. I'm going to give you another chance. And tell me, who is that God that's going to deliver you out of my hand? If I were to ask you today, who is this God? I'd get all kinds of answers. And I'd run out of all options. Because there are words enough to express how great this God is. The one that allowed you to wake up this morning. How great this God is! The one that gave you breath in your body. How great this God is! Who is that God that has the capacity to deliver you out of my hand and out of this house? The boy stood there. Told he can't give it me so. He's still able. Any of y'all know he's able to do anything? There are any limitations on him. He has no ceiling over his head. Who is that God? Oh my God, sometimes my little mind likes to look back over in the creation. And wonder how great he is. Who is that God that has the ability to deliver? Don't you see that fire? It's hot. Who is he? My God. Somebody say he's Jehovah Nissi. He's your God. Somebody say he's Jehovah's God. He will make a way. Somebody say he's Jehovah Shammah. He is your shepherd. Somebody say Jehovah Rapha. He is the great physician. Somebody say he's Jehovah Rea. He's the Lord, my shepherd. Someone said he's Jehovah Tiskudu. He is a God of our righteousness. Oh, who is that God? How mighty he is. Oh, God of virtue. He is El Shaddai. He's almighty. Anybody know that he's almighty? Who is that God? She decided one day, I will make me a world. Think about it. He didn't have to go get a building permit. He didn't have to have an inspection. When you made it, you turned around and inspected it himself. Pat himself on the shoulder and say, that's good. Who is that God? We're not in the empty space. That can't be. And things start happening as never before. Who is that God? So we stretched our arms and dug out the muddy Mississippi River, pulled up water in the Atlantic Ocean and held it in the palm of his hand. Who is that God? Looked out over the hillside and dressed up in a suit of fine green grass, turned around and decorated with lilies and sunflower all over the place. Who is that God? He can. He's able to deliver us out of your hand. And anything else you got planned, he's still able to deliver us from it. So they came. Boaz had made their minds up, we're not going to bow. Now he gets angry. Oh my God, he's a, his face starts changing. Frowns over his face, and these little rascals talking to me like that. I'm a king. Told him to turn the heat up. Turn it hot. It's already hot, but turn it up hot. But the boys still had their minds made up. I want you to know sometimes you got to go through some stuff. But you have to have your mind made up. Every child of God is going to have a test. But God is not going to allow you to be tested above that that you're able to bear. When you're going through a test and you came out victoriously, don't get beside yourself. You didn't do it by yourself. You did it because the Lord was on your side. You came out shouting the victory because God was on your side. So what the devil does is he turns up the heat on you. You came through that, but I want to test you, and this time you're not going to come out. But you make your mind up, come hell or high water, I'm coming through this, and I'm coming out of this, and no weapon to come against me shall prosper, because the Lord is on my side. Can I get a witness in the house? Can I get a witness? So then the devil turned the heat up. Turn it up. Turn up the thermostat. I'm still coming out. Hallelujah. I'm still coming out. Turn it up, Satan. Send all your demons over here. Go back and get some old time demons. Some young time demons. Bring all your demons in my mind and say, God. Anybody in the house can say right now, my mind is made up. I'm not going to panic because the heat is turned up. I'm not going to throw the towel in and go running crying the blues because my mind is made up. I refuse to sing the blues. I'm going to be the king and he who sing the blues. And I'm going to sing how I got over. Oh, Lord, come on. Refuge in the house. Get a Refuge in the house. Come in. Let me slow down here. I'm getting a little too emotional right now. Oh God, I praise you. Let me get back. Some of y'all looking at me. You're gonna be tested. To walk around crying because the devil is giving you a hard time. Don't you know he's just doing his job? And God's allowing him to do his job so you can do your job. Hello. Hello. The devil on my track. So what? Put it on his track. Resist it. And he'll flee from you. Get back. Oh God, I praise you. Get behind me. Somebody watch this. Somebody say, why are you wanting to get behind me? Lord told you to have your feet shod with the preparation of the gospel of peace. So you have the Lord heard about the truth. The breastplate of righteousness is shield of faith. The helmet of salvation. Ain't nothing on your back. Why would you tell the devil to get behind? Lord, David said, not getting off from the text, but walk through the night of the shadow of death. I'm still weeping because the rod and the staff they comfort me. When the enemy comes from the right side, pushes me to the left, the rod is holding me up. When you come from the left side and push me to the right, my staff got me. There's nothing on my back. But I heard him say, when it ever comes to attack me from behind, say, goodness and mercy shall follow me. Goodness and mercy got my back. So when I tell him to get behind me, goodness and mercy got my back. So I can tell him to get behind me, I don't have to worry about it. Up. Well, make sure he gonna burn me. You have some barbecue too. Oh God, I praise you. Somebody gonna die. But these boys still have their minds made up. They're sitting in the strong band now. These three teenagers, the devil, the mind of Nebuchadnezzar was so enraged until he had a mighty man of his army to come and throw them inside of the fire. Now, the Lord didn't deliver these boys in the fire. Oh God, I praise you. Woo. The Lord didn't deliver these boys in the fire. Somebody looking at me funny. Somebody's a turtle like a yo-yo. The Lord didn't deliver these boys in the fire. The men, the soldiers, that took them to the fire was so intensified until they slew them. If it slew the men that took them to the fire, that means the boys should have been slain before we got in the fire. Deliverance came before we got in the fire. When we got in the fire was a place to celebrate. Oh God. They were so excited to start walking around in the fire. Shadrach, I don't know if they had been eating by the cut out in advance. If it had been Sister Ruth, you might have thrown a hand up and start praising, falling out all over the place. Can I get a witness? If it didn't sit in the community, it might be in German language. Great song. Yeah, that's right. Can I get a minute in there? The boy saw walking around in the fire. And King looked inside of the fire and felt like he was having an optical illusion. He said, didn't he cast in three men? But there's another man. When you're going through your test, you're not going through alone. It's another man. Thank you, Father. Hallelujah. When you're going through your stuff, you're not by yourself. There's another man. See, didn't he cast in three? But there's another one in here. And he looked like the Son of God. Thank you, Jesus. Oh, God. The boys were in the fire. And the half still was unchanged. Walking around in the cold, didn't even smell like smoke. Somebody said, I don't look like what I've been through. Hallelujah. Oh, glory. Can I preach a while? Give me a little time. This other man looked like Son of God. You know, I call it his angel. Some said it was a pre-incarnation. Oh, Christ before he was incarnated. But then Nebuchadnezzar says a few verses later that God sent his angel. Praise God. So they all go there. They all go over that theologians. I just know there's another man in the fire. Hallelujah. Oh, glory. And the boys came out. They came out. And I say that to say this. You got to go through some stuff. But you can't panic because the test is more intensified. You can't panic before the odds are against you. Any odd was against those boys. They were not supposed to come out, but there was a God. Hallelujah. There was a God that was able. And there is a God now that's able to bring you out. The devil comes against you. He comes against your finances. He comes against your physical needs. He comes against your spiritual needs. And in one of these situations, he's able to bring you out. He said, I'll bless you when you go out. And I'll bless you when you come back in. Oh, God, I praise you. I'll bless your hands. I'll bless your basket. I'll bless you with all these blessings will overtake you. When you're going to be blessed, I'll have my blessings go past you. And when you get there, you're going to meet my blessing. Can I get a blessing to praise? In the house of the Lord. Your blessing may be in New York City, and you don't know where it is, but you're on your way toward your blessing. And when you get there, your blessing say, good morning, I've been waiting on you. And somebody to the Lord to praise in the house of the Lord. There's saints of God, you're going through stuff. The demons are scattered there. Get in the midst of your finances. And telling you that you're not going to make it. The man, the foreclosure might be on the house. Snatch man coming to get the car. Already got an eviction notice on the door. But tell your neighbor, the end is not yet. Don't panic. Cannot get a witness in here. Oh, don't panic. There's a God somewhere. Anybody know who that God is? He can rise. He's able to deliver us. He's able to bring you out. He says, there's a God somewhere. said, it's high and look low. There's a God somewhere that said, hold on, I'll be there. Oh, there's a God somewhere. Well, they know, yes, he is. Anybody know he's here? I'm paying my tithe. I'm giving the Lord my money. And still the tax man coming. Still the foreclosure notice is over. Still the eviction notice is on. My water's cut off. I heard from this coast town spending the money on long talk side. But I'm still holding. Anybody know what I'm talking about? Oh, praise our God. Praise the name of our God. I'm going to hold on because he's going to bring me out. If I lose the house, he got a better one for me. If someone need to pull some of these old random cars away, went down to buy him, pay him, pay $2,000 for a $300 car. Need to pull it away. Y'all don't look at me so funny. So the Lord can bless you. Hallelujah. Tell your neighbor there's a blessing on the way. Don't panic. There's a blessing on the way. Tell another neighbor, don't panic. There's a blessing on the way. Hallelujah. And it's yours. It's yours. Come on, say it's yours. But it ain't mine. You got yours, and I got mine. I'm going to praise God for yours because I want you to be blessed. But I'm going to double praise him for me because you're bringing me out of my lips. Oh, God, I praise you. And yes, sir. The demon of hell may come trying to destroy you. But lift your head up, put a smile on your face. Put a phrase in your mouth. Clap your hands and magnify God. Because you know that you know that you know. And God is coming down in the midst of your furnace. The fire may be hot, but you're not going to burn up. The fire may be hot, but you're going to come out praising God. The fire may be hot. You're going to get a shout. The fire may be hot. You're going to celebrate. You're going to celebrate. You're going to celebrate. Because God is in that fire.
Thank you.
the shot. If the baby is not home, you need to protect this God. Lord, your God, the hero of your sickness, I just say, you wounded, on the command transgressions, you bruised, the landing, and the testament of my peace, was upon you, and healed already. The cancer we have, God, let him heal. You got the most we have. I'm going to rejoice. I'm going to magnify. I'm going to praise God.
And rebuke death. The deed was finished.